Hello, today for review I've got interesting affordable in-ear monitors made by company Tingker, not sure about the correct pronunciation, but if you don't know about this company, it's a sister brand of AudioSense, and AudioSense is pretty well known creator of Chinese in-ear monitors. And they proved that they can create interesting models. I reviewed a lot of their creations and I'm a fan of this brand, so I was interested in Tingker. And in the past they released few models that gather pretty lot of attention, so TK300 is also pretty promising model. As you can see, it uses Knowles dual balanced armature and 9.7 mm dynamic driver. So, a good setup to create something with a decent sound. Like 7 or 8 years ago, for such set of drivers, you'll have to pay $300 or $400. But now you can get that amount of drivers and that setup for just $100. I will add links to the AliExpress shop in the description, and today let's have a closer look. So, package is simple but pretty nice, good polygraphy, nice combination of black and white, pleasant to touch because it has that velvety soft touch effect. And as usual, it opens like matchbox, and on top there is tips. You get two set of silicone tips. We've seen them many times before, green stem and regular gray ones. Manual with short information. Actually, did they print some technical specifications somewhere? Not here. And warranty terms, conditions, maintains, repair form, no. Unfortunately, no technical specifications, but it's not that important, of course. And inner case, you can clearly see that most probably it's made on the same plant that create cases for the campfire audio, or someone shamelessly ripped campfire audio cases, because it definitely designed and looks in a similar way. And inside we'll have the earphones with stock cable. So let's move case aside, get a pair of tips, and now we can talk about the design. So I like green stem tips, but usually gray one fits better. And you can see in terms of design, it's almost classical in terms of shape. It's better like cylindrical main shape with pretty well extended spout. Most probably there won't be any issues with fit because they are small in footprint, they fitting nicely into ears. They have slightly above average sound isolation because the earpiece itself isolates well. There is a small pressure relief hole on the outer side, lip for holding the tips, protective grill, so everything is done typically well for modern in-ear monitors. They are made of metal, they have a interesting design and good style, and of course they are built well. Cables are made replaceable, here used MMCX connectors, they fitting pretty tightly with well-defined clicks, so most probably they will serve for a long time because they look pretty reliable. So for $100 it's a really nice build quality and all other stuff. Stock cable is also pretty good. You can see ear hooks are pretty stiff, but they are holding well and they doing their job nicely. They reduce the microphonic effect of cable. Cable is average in terms of softness, not super soft, but not super hard, something in between. Looks pretty attractive, nicely braided, so here is splitter with chin slider, and after splitter it goes braided down to the jack, so pretty good cable. So all that presentational stuff, package, accessory set, design and so on are done on a really good level for the $100 in-ear monitors. And of course about the sound, I gave them about 40 hours of burn-in, but there were no great changes in sound, so there is not much sense in spending time burning them in. So if you get them, just get the proper tips and start listening. Let's have a player on the table to provide some examples and talk about their representation. So Tingker is experienced company, maybe themselves or their sister company AudioSense, and creating this model, they have a targeted audience in mind. They created a pretty bass head model for those who like warmer and bassy sound, but at the same time it's pretty nicely compensated with balanced armatures, so it's kind of reasonable type of bass head models. And the bass here is deep, it's accented, it's pretty big, it goes to the good depths, maybe not the maximum one, but pretty deep. And actually they sacrificed a bit of resolution in order to create more weight, in order to create a warmer sound. It's not super dry or super fast bass, but of course it's not super slow, so it's somewhere in between, fairly well balanced, with nice good weight and impact. It suits the best of all, of course, for electronic music and for genres that benefit from synthesized low frequencies. But if you like low frequencies, it will be also good with acoustic instruments and so on. But keep in mind that acoustic instruments will be a bit exaggerated in size because of the accented low frequencies. It's pretty nice in rendering textures, but losing a bit of tiny nuances in the low frequency domain. So it's not the model for the rich audiophilic overtones, but it's the model for the pleasant and weighty foundation in music. So it's just a model that created for those who like such low frequencies representation. And as an example, pretty obviously, I'll get the Prodigy Breeze. Nice big bass, and that model delivers it at really good level, with that sense of resonance with eardrums shaking pressure. It's not the biggest bass I've heard, but it's definitely above average. Lower mids are recessed because it's basically V-shaped signature, but thanks to the balanced armatures, they not sound veiled, and actually bass is pretty well controlled here. Also, they are good in terms of coherence, transitions between drivers are done almost smoothly. So mids have good resolution, they have good weight, so fairly well balanced. They don't go to the micro contrast too far, and they not sound typical for the balanced armatures, but they will give you a good resolution, they will give you good amount of emotions, but at the same time they won't try to highlight something or to hide something, really well balancing between the micro and macro side of things. And they realize to a noticeable limit on the good records of good quality to show the full potential on the mids. Instruments show the character really well, vocals are nice, especially female ones, because upper mids are boosted and that gives additional clarity, it gives additional presence, a bit of additional aggression for the guitars and so on. And in terms of imaginary stage, they are slightly above average. It's typical for the warmer balanced, for the warmer sounding earphones, at least for me. On the bass heavy models, I'm not getting super spacious stage, but they are above average, so for me it's already a good result. And as an example for the mid frequencies, another nostalgic track, but actually bigger part of my media library is based on nostalgia. It's Rage, Let the Night Begin. Great riffs, great chorus, nice bridges, so just raw, powerful metal as we like it, or maybe not we, as I like it. And this earphones plays it nicely. A bit of added aggression and pretty nice drums thanks to the boosted low frequencies. So it's a nice type of representation for such tracks. But of course it's a matter of preferences here, because many people like, for example, more aggressive and dry representation or some other representation. And treble, so lower part of treble is also accented, but not too much. I won't call this model treble heavy. Maybe super treble sensitive people can find them too bright, but I think that there won't be issues with treble for most of the listeners. And the upper part of treble is a bit recessed in order to create a more comfortable sound and in order not to hide the low frequencies here. So basic lower part of treble is present, sounds nicely, but it's lacking, of course, super layering, rich overtone saturation. It's just basic treble to show the basic tones and cymbals, percussions and so on. Sounds nicely thanks to the balanced armatures, but don't expect like super rich decays. And as an example for the treble, yet another piece of nostalgia going even further in past. It's Marillion, Misplaced Childhood. Great example of neo-progressive genre. If you like it, or even if you don't like it, I really recommend this album. It's a great masterpiece. It's complex, but not overcomplicated. And great vocal, nice percussions, all that stuff that requires basic treble representation, and this model delivers it. In terms of pairings, they don't require something super high-end. You can even use it with smartphones, but to show the full potential, you will need some digital to analog converter or entry-level player. I like them with Hydis most of all, but Fios M6 also doing a good job here. Speaking about the compressions, because of their bass-heavy nature, they are standing aside from the rest of compression. You know, it kind of reminds me KZ ZAX, for example, but a bit more natural and a bit better balanced. Most probably, I think it's because of balanced armatures used here. You know, Knowles is still Knowles, if it prepared properly and it can deliver that. And the rest of models that I can recall usually have less low frequencies. Or if we speak about some bass heavy models like TFZ models that I've tested, P-Audio, Tingker has more treble and has more better tonal balance. So can't recall any other bass heavy model, so won't do a lot of comparisons today. To summarize everything, nice model for those who like boosted bass and a bit warmer representation and comfortable treble and detailed mids. So maybe it's not the model for everyone, but it's fitting nicely into target audience and delivers good value for those who like such signature. Thank you for listening, thank you for your attention, and have a nice day.